Well, tonight the dreaded R word is looming large over financial markets. Recession, something Australia hasn't seen in 28 years. Global stock markets are falling heavily as fears increase.
The tom-tom drums are beating. Almost $60 billion was cut from our stock market's value today as investors cut and run, worried about trade wars, Hong Kong and interest rates. But our government is holding its line.
We are in our 28th year of continuous growth. Our economy continues to grow.
The recession talk amped up when last night in America, interest rates for two-year government bonds jumped higher than for 10-year bonds. In economic speak, this is called an inverse yield curve, and it's a classic sign of an economic downturn or future recession. The last time this signal was seen was just before the global financial crisis in 2007.
I think the bond market's making a very clear statement right now, which is trade wars are horrible for the global economy. And
Donald Trump chimed in, again putting pressure on the independent US Federal Reserve.
If we had a Fed that would lower interest rates, we'd be like a rocket ship.
Last year, Nine News flagged the prospect that a global slowdown was on the way.
We think we could easily tip slightly into a, not a really deep recession, but into a recession nonetheless.
And today, Robert Mead with PIMCO, one of the largest government bond managers in the world, has not changed his view.
The likelihood of recession continues to go up.
But suggestions the government should abandon its budget surplus promise and instead hand out more tax cuts, more stimulus, are falling on deaf ears.
We will continue to implement our plan for a stronger economy, for more jobs, and to ensure that government lives within its means.
So one of the issues right now is while the chance of a global recession might be rising here in Australia because of strong iron ore sales over the past 6 months, it's not likely to happen here, at least immediately. This was sort of borne out in today's employment numbers. Unemployment was steady, 5.2%, but lots more people are clearly looking for work right now. We're talking about families needing extra income, older Australians as well. So one of the big issues is that many of these families are already technically in their own recession, along with industry. Industries such as construction and also retail. This is going to put pressure on the Reserve Bank, some suggesting they might even cut rates twice by the end of this year, and the earliest time could be as early as next month, September. Andrew?
Thanks, Ross. No wonder a few are looking nervous.
Hi, YouTubers. I'm Davina Smith. Well, click here to keep watching Great Nine videos and subscribe to our channel here for lots more news, analysis and exclusive content. For breaking news, see you at 9news.com.au.